And because I was in that atmosphere, because I was thinking those thoughts, I was starting to manifest those kind of characteristics. Amen, praise God. And I began to treat women like I was, like I seen how they were treated. Because my father was gone, he was in prison. My mother was working all the time, so I just had my brothers around. And so I learned from them and the other people how to treat women. And it wasn't a good way how I treated them. Amen, praise God. It wasn't good to expose women to that kind of environment and to have that kind of mentality. That was wrong. Amen, praise God. And so it took a force greater than myself to change my direction. I wanted to do good, but ha, glory to God. Hey, yes. Man, hallelujah, glory to God.
Yes. Yes.
Every time I went to do good, evil would present itself.
Amen.
And I would sit back, I would be up in college and say, God, there got to be more than life than what I'm living.
Yeah.
There got to be more than drinking. Mm-hmm. Got to be more than running out to nightclubs and doing this. And it got to be more than that. But I can't stop myself. And Paul said, who shall deliver me from this wretched body? Who will change my direction? What remedy is there to this ailment that I have? Is there a cure to this disease? Is there a balm in Gilead? Is there something that I can do to help me change the way that I think? Hallelujah, glory to God. Paul reveals that there is one. His name is Jesus Christ.
Yes, it is. There is
one. Hey, glory to God. There is one. There is a man. There is a man. His name is Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. And when he found that revelation that this man, Jesus Christ, was the one that gave him the strength to break loose from carnality, to break loose from the lust of the flesh, to break loose from sin, to break loose from the power of darkness, from the strength of sin that had him bound through the commandments he was trying to keep. Oh, hallelujah, glory to God, in order to be right. Do you not know that bad things can happen to good people?
Yes. Amen.
Oh, hallelujah, glory to God, amen. You're doing all that's within your willpower to do right, to live right, to walk right, to talk right, but still there's something that just grabs you and won't let you go. It's like a spirit, an imp, or a demon in a person through their thoughts and their languages that try to hold you down and confine you to where you're at. Amen, praise God. And it usually takes an event for you releasing who you are for real to break loose out of that situation. Amen. What am I saying? You come to a point in yourself where you say, you know what, enough is enough.
Yeah.
It's enough. Something in you rises up because you're sick and tired. Y'all gotta catch that of being sick and tired. You're just done with this. You're done with this relationship. Done with this attitude. Done with this mindset. Yeah. Done with this situation. Done with this problem. Well, done with this person. Yeah. Done with this these people. Hey man, it's something in you that says, there's more than me than how you treat me. Oh, hallelujah. There's more to me than what I'm experiencing. There's more to me than what I see in front of me. I need a change. I need a revolution. I need something to break down the forces around me. I can't do it by myself. Lord, send some help. Oh, give God some hand praise. Amen. Glory to God. And right there in that thought process, you're experiencing the power of God. Because yes. God is not giving you the spirit of fear.
Yes.
But of love, power, and a sound mind. And this urge for soundness begins to rise up in you.
Amen.
This urgeness for love begins to rise up in you. This urgeness for power begins. You begin to get strength out of nowhere. You look back as you broke loose. You look back and say, man, how'd I do that?
How'd I do that?
And see, women have this uncanny ability to speak real, like real soft. I know when my mom got real soft, we like, uh-oh. When she stopped talking to us, we like, dog, dude. We be like, you go get it. I'm saying, get it, boy. I'll talk to you after dinner. We like, ooh. Go ahead, eat your dinner, get ready for bed. When she said, take your clothes off and get ready for bed, we already knew it. She might see what time it just right. As soon as you drop the pen, bam, I told you, pow. I dread it. I mean, it took me like all night to eat my macaroni and cheese. I mean, I was the last one. I was one macaroni at a time. Like, seriously, one macaroni at a time. your switch. She said, go out there and cut your switch. Man, I'm telling you. She said, go cut your switch. And you better not come back with no little twin. Better not. And then, see, we had those kind of branches that they peel the skin off. Remember those branches in the back where you peel the skin off? And that green be all slick and wet. That's what she hit us with. Pow! Whoa, man. It taught us a lesson. Amen. Hallelujah, glory to God. Amen.
Hallelujah.
And sometimes it takes that to shake us loose.
Yeah. Yeah.
To get us back on track again. It takes an event. Amen. Yeah. Praise God. To snap us back into reality.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And sometimes when you're in relationships, I've seen this among women a lot, is that you know when they say, you got one more time, bro. You got one more time. Put your hands on me. Put your hands on me. Go ahead, go to sleep. I got you. Go ahead, sleep. Nice. Everything is cool. You okay? Yeah, babe, I'm okay. I'm fine. Go ahead and go to sleep. Oh, I forgive you. Everything is okay. I love you too. So right till that joke is sleep, I'm burning the house down. Women have done that. They burnt the house down. Pour hot grease on him while he's asleep. What drives a woman to do that? Because they're sick and tired of going through that same old stuff.
Amen.
Something in them, they get power, they get strength from somewhere. 98-pound woman take down a 250-pound man. Naturally, that's impossible, but she gets strength somewhere on the inside of her. She'll just grab his neck at the right time and lock in like a pit bull and not let go. Maybe like, yeah, I'm sorry. Amen, praise God. For real, there's something, there's a power, there's a force that rises up in all of us. Not just male, and just not the female, but it rises up in the male. Uncanny strength to do extraordinary things in a time of emergency. Amen. And men do that too. They get, little fella like me, wouldn't look like I'm much. 180, 190 pounds. Amen, praise God. But I tell you something, in one winter, it was what, last winter, I was pouring antifreeze in my vehicle, and the top, as I poured the bottom off, the top smashed down on my finger, and it locked. The top locked. Yeah, that hurt. And yeah, it was close to the front of the car. Yeah, and it didn't just. I thought my finger was gone. I didn't even want to look at it. Because it slammed from its upright position. It was a Bonneville, 91 Bonneville, GM. That's a full-size car. Wasn't no little car. And it slammed down. Bang! And it locked. Click, click. I'm outside across the street. My brother's up with his window closed. And it was winter. Cold. And the cold kept my finger from being chopped off. Because it was froze. My fingers were froze. And because it was so cold, I couldn't feel the pain.
Amen.
And at first, I panicked because I couldn't get my finger out. But then I calmed down and I said, God, I need strength. And what I did, I was able to lift the end as it was locked. I pulled the hood up because I said, if I don't do this, my finger's gone. And I can't keep it under here that long because it had broke skin. It had broke skin. So I pulled it up and I was able to slide my finger out. And when I pulled it up, I felt it was a determination. It was, I can't even describe it. But normally I couldn't have did that. And I literally pulled that car up, that hood up, and it was still locked. It didn't come unlocked. And I was able to pull it up far enough, bend it up, pull the steel hood up enough to slide my finger out. And I went into the house, and I didn't put it underwater right away. I pulled out that hydrogen peroxide, poured that in a bowl, in a cup, and I stuck my finger in it to destroy all the bacteria right away. Amen. And I didn't want to put it under the water because then that pain would come real. I mean, because it would start to thaw out. It would start to thaw out. I feel that pain. Amen. And so my finger began to heal from that. Amen. Praise God. And I got all the, and I was able to keep my finger and was able to get it out. But that taught me that in the midst of emergency, you will, there will be strength that you will pull from internally in a case of a situation like that, in emergencies. And so what Paul was doing, he didn't have enough strength to pull from to do right. He thought he had a lost cause, but he found a power source. Y'all gotta help me, amen. He found a power source, something else that he could draw from that equalized his situation, that leveled the playing field that he was on. He says, yeah, I'm dealing with this evil, but now I got backup. Y'all gotta help me, amen. Hallelujah, glory to God. I got a generator now. I got another source I can draw from that will enable me to overcome this law that's working in my members, trying to pull me into the captivity of sin.